Hi everyone, welcome, and talking to you today from Cape Town, and it's a very rainy day today. You can probably hear the rain outside. I wanted to speak about how we can find the gift in even very challenging and difficult situations. And there's a gift in everything, and it's something that I know on some level, but I feel like some of the things that have happened to me, and I see other people in my circles as well, things that happen that seem to be really hard and challenging. There's always a gift if we look for it, and if we are patient enough, and if we just wait, you know, have a bit of patience to see the bigger picture. There is a gift in everything. I was thinking about my dog this morning, and you know, I often think about her in relation to this, because there are times that, you know, of course, like our children, our animals, they are challenging and they drive us crazy, and there are times that, of course, she does. She drives me crazy. And then I look at just the hundreds of gifts that this dog has brought to my life. You know, and some of those gifts are that she gave me the gift of learning how to be a mother and how to look after someone. She gave me the gift of connecting to my inner child practically every day, because she's so funny and she brings so much joy to me. And when I take her out for walks, her face is so cute. It lights me up, you know, and it connects me instantly to my inner child and to the playfulness inside of me, even amongst a very stressful, busy day. So she is so thoughtful and she, you know, she knows, when I need like a cuddle, and she'll come and sit with me, and I know when, you know, when she needs love, you know, when she's scared or when she needs support. So yeah, there's so much joy that she brings me. And even in our life, you know, there are challenges that come up, but they are all like, one of the things that I'm learning is that everything is actually for us. You know, nothing happens to us. Yeah, there are a few things that do happen in this world that I don't condone. So I can't say that nothing, but most things happen to us, for our highest. They actually are for us. And sometimes in the moment, we don't see that, and we can't acknowledge that, and we want to push it away. But actually, you know, so many things in our lives, if not everything, happens for us to teach us, to help us to grow, to help us to grow into new parts of ourselves, to help us to expand our consciousness, you know. I find it very fascinating how incidences happen in our lives which can trigger a massive change. That could be amazing, it could be very challenging, but it's happening because we needed that change. Our highest required us to learn something different, something new. And so, I am in a new phase of my life right now, where I'm in a new home. So much newness, actually, new chapter, and I'm curious about what this new chapter is going to bring. But I also know that I'm here because I'm ready for something different and something new. And you know, there are certain parts of my work that I'm good at, but I also have been frustrated with. And then I think one of the things that I'm learning about is that, you know, there are gifts and talents that we have that we've embodied and we've come to this lifetime with for a reason. And there are people out there that actually require those gifts. And so it's helped me to shift a certain mindset within myself around some of the work that I offer and some of especially my work around my design business, because I actually run a company called Elevation Design. It's been something that I've been doing for a long time. And sometimes it requires a lot of technical work. And, you know, I've actually got a really amazing brain for computers. And I've always been so good at, with computers. Even back when I was 8, 9 years old, I was already on those old DOS computers, like on the C drive, you know, doing my thing, like very, very tech, you know, since I was very, very young. And I'm very grateful for that side of me, because I've been able to create so much that some people find very, very difficult. You know, for me, I can create my own flyers and my own websites and my own logos, and it's fantastic, you know, to be able to do all those things. And you know, but sometimes that work, it's hard work and it's stressful. And there have been times in my life where I've pushed that work away. I'm like, I don't want to do this anymore. Yet people keep coming to me and asking me for help there, you know. So it's really interesting. Like, I've been really attempting to embrace all the talents and the gifts that I have. And even when things have been challenging, you know, I'll give you an example. The other day, I had a client who was really quite mean, actually, and very aggressive in my design business. And like, it's quite a long story in a sense, because I have had that particular type of client 2 or 3 times in the past, where I didn't handle it very well in the past, where I actually was scared of them. I kind of allowed myself to be abused. Like, I got really angry and I didn't respond very well. Where this time I stood up for myself and I was able to hold myself together and be firm, and I said to this man, do not speak to me like that. And I was able to meet this fear, because that type of character I've been very afraid of in the past. And I met that, and the next day he paid me, and it was amazing because I could see the shift. And so sometimes, even though we might be doing work, sometimes we maybe are sometimes bored with, and we don't understand why we're doing it. We are there for a reason. And there are, you know, hundreds of people that I help with my dance and movement work, and through sound healing. Lots of people that I help. And there are lots of people that I help through my graphic design business, my web design business. And there are lessons everywhere, and there are gifts everywhere. You know, there's beautiful gifts in so many places if we just take the time to pause and pay attention. I invite you to take this next week to really slow down and to really observe and sense and feel around you the gifts that are there right in front of you, and to be grateful. Gratitude is one of the keys, one of the doorways to real empowerment and real change. If we can really sit and be grateful for what we have and look at the gifts that certain things have brought us. Sometimes pain is often a great door. Sometimes illness can be a door. And I've seen and witnessed incredible human beings that have had, you know, that have gone through really difficult things, cancer, like really difficult illnesses, that have used it as a door. And those people really inspire me. Like, they really, really inspire me, because those lessons are hard. But if you were to ask those people for the gift, they'd be able to write a book on it, because they've gone through it. And there is a gift in everything. There's a gift in every pain. There's a gift in sadness. You know, there is a gift in even feeling really lost and stuck. I've gone through spaces in my life where I felt very, very, very lost. And sometimes being lost and being confused, as long as you're not in those spaces for too long, sometimes those spaces can actually be really, really good for you. Because what's happening is that we're, something is shifting, you know, something is changing, and we're like, ah, what's that? What's that? You know, like, I can't grasp it. It's because there's something that's actually changing, and if we just wait and patient, it starts to reveal itself. So, you know, when we're doing the same thing all the time and there's no change, you know, that's when there's problems. I believe that change is really important. We need to be able to flow with it and move with it. And yeah, embrace what, you know, what we are here to actually learn and to trust. Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.